IdL b by 2 t theta by 2 q 2 cancel, then IR dl value what here, length of an arc equal to radius into I, that is theta into arc equal to d theta, theta theta cancel, IR. Okay, after that, if these are conductor having the length of L total length, a particular circular shape of radius r, what is the perimeter 2 pi r equal to L, then r equal to L by 2 pi, that is written here, I L V by 2 pi. That is the tension acting along the wire.
Tension acting along the wire. Okay.
So with that example over.
Now, with that one, force acting on current carrying conductor
and related problems we have completed.
The next topic what I am going to discuss is
force acting between two parallel current carrying conductors.
What is the next one?
Force acting between two parallel current carrying conductors.
Okay,
that we are going to.
Force acting between two parallel current carrying conductors of infinite length. Okay, that is the heading. Force acting between two long parallel current carrying conductors. Okay, that topic we are going to discuss. Let's see that. Consider two long, mean infinite length conductors. These are the two parallel current carrying conductors separated by distance of r, carrying the currents I1 and I2 in the same direction,
and they were placed in the A.
Okay.
Now, what is the force acting on the first conductor due to second conductor and vice versa? That force magnitude we want to get. See, first of all, I want to get force on the second conductor due to first one. For that, what I am doing? Due to this conductor, what is the B value here?
Due to first conductor, what is the magnetic field induction at the second conductor?
See, it is a long current carrying conductor carrying the current of I1. Then B direction what here? Field induction due to first one equal to how much? Mu naught I1 by 2 pi r.
It is a field induction due to first conductor that to acting in downward direction. Okay.
Now, in this field, this conductor is there.
The conductor is there.
Now, I want to get force acting on this conductor of length L.
For example, if you want to get a force, you have to take small element. That element having the length of L here. Okay, I am choosing small element of this connector of length L. Of length L, second connector.
Now, what is the force acting on this connector, on this small element?
Force on second connector element. Of length L is F equal to formula 1 I L D sin theta, theta mean 90 here because L is like B bar is number L bar cos B bar L bar cos B bar. So F force acting on second connector due to first one equal to current value what L I to length what L.
What is the B value?
B1. What is I to L into? What is B1 value? U0 I1 by 2 pi r. It is a force acting on the first connector, second connector element of length L. Small element of length L. Okay.
But if you want to write a force by length,
what we are getting U0 by 2 pi I1 I2 by R.
What is the direction of force?
L bar cos B bar. So force is acting towards first connector. This is the direction of force on second connector due to first connector. Okay, that is over. Similarly, we want to get
force acting on first connector
due to second connector. Due to second connector.
How can we get that same method? First, due to this second connector, what is the B value here?
What is the magnetic field induction at the place of first connector?
What is the B direction here?
Current upward, B is outward. Outward. So, here field direction is outward, that is the B2. What is the B2 value? Mu naught I2 by 2 pi r. Mu naught I2 by 2 pi r.
Now you take small element of this, of length L.
Okay, then what is the force acting on that element? ILD sin theta R I L bar cross B bar.
So force acting on first connector due to second connector equal to I1 L B2. I1
L B2.
Okay.
So what is I1 L into B2 value mu naught I2 by 2 pi R. That is the mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi R into L. What is the direction of that force on the second connector due to first one?
This is.
And what is the force direction on first one due to second one?
L bar cross B bar.
L bar cross B bar. So, right words. Yes, one.
That means force on second connector,
force on first connector, both are towards each other.
That means they are getting attracting each other.
They are attracting each other.
Anyhow, what is the force acting per unit length here?
The force acting per unit length equal to mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r.
So, F1 2 pi L and F2 1 pi L both are equal. What is the force per unit length?
Force per unit length of two parallel current carrying connectors
is equal to mu naught I1 question you studied well. Ampere is the unit for electrical current. Electrical current is a fundamental quantity. Then you studied a definition for current. That definition is here. From this equation only, the definition was given. What is the definition? Let's see here. Ampere we want to define here. How to define ampere here means, if I1 and I2 both are equal, then I1 and I2 are 1 ampere. What about force per unit length value? In the A, the force per unit length is A, R equal to 1 meter, then that means these are the two conductors carrying the currents 1 ampere and 1 ampere in the air, separated by distance of 1 meter. Separated by distance of 1 meter. Then, what about F by L value? Mu naught by 2 pi. That is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 Newton per meter. Newton per meter. Now, how do we define that ampere law mean? The current flowing through each conductor of infinite length. Two conductors, each conductor of infinite length, placed parallelly in the air at a 1 meter separation, such that the force per unit length between them is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 Newton per meter. Okay, is called 1 ampere. Okay, the current flowing through each conductor of infinite length placed parallel in the air at 1 meter separation, such that the force per unit length between them is this much. Then the current is called what?
1 ampere. What we call it? 1 ampere. Okay.
That is the definition of 1 ampere from this equation. Okay. And main point to remember here is, the main point to remember here is, whenever current moving parallel in the same direction, they get attracted each other. And whenever current moving in opposite direction, then they repel each other. Already I showed you the diagram. These two are getting attracted now. But whereas the current is opposite, they are getting repelling each other. Okay, that we are going to write here. And note, very important point is, the conductors attract
difference each other. Okay. Do remember it well. What is the force per unit length between two current carrying conductors of infinite length mean? What did I tell you? That is F by L equal to mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r. That is the most important formula related to this topic. Now see example problem related to this. Infinite current carrying conductor is there, carrying the current I1, carrying the current I1. Nearer to that, I have placed a current carrying conductor, carrying the current I2, and its length is B, it was placed at a distance of A. What is the force acting on the small conductor due to long conductor? That is the question here. Question what here? Find force on small conductor due to long conductor. Due to long conductor. That is the question. How can we get that? It is actually current carrying conductor of finite length of B. Finite length of B. I am going to take small elemental portion because the B value due to this is going to vary from point to point here. B value varies from point to point. Due to that, first, if we are taking small current carrying element of length dx, it is the element of length dx. It is small element of length dx. Whichever chosen at a distance of x, over that small element I want to get force first. What is the force mean? First of all, force value whenever you want to get. We need to write the field value here. What is the field induction here? The field induction here is dB equal to mu naught. Okay. A field induction B equal to mu naught I1 by 2 pi x. What is the field direction here? Inward. See, thumb rule. So, field direction is inward. In that field, a small element is there of length dx. Then what is the force acting on that? That force is equal to ILB sin 90. I mean what here? I took. L mean what here? Dx. B mean this is mu naught I1 by 2 by x. Sin 90. Because B bar is inward, dx bar is horizontal. Then dx bar and B bar are having the angle of 90 degrees between them. By that I write here sin 90. After getting the force on a small element, we want to get force on total conductor. So total force. Integral df equal to integral. What are the limits for x here? For covering the total conductor, x value varies from a to a plus b. So, limits are a to a plus b. Mu naught
What are the leads? A to A plus B.
A to A plus B.
If you apply the leads, what can I get in? Mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi log of A plus B by A. It is a force.
What is the force direction here?
L bar cross B bar, that is upward. Force direction what here? Upward.
Force direction is upward. Okay.
So with that this problem over. Write down this example problem.
Second example.
There is infinite current carrying conductor. Carrying current I.
Carrying the current I1.
Sorry.
Okay.
And from this one, it is distance of A. At a distance of A, I have placed a conductor of length 2A carrying the current I2. It is the conductor. Carrying the current I2, what is the length of the conductor 2A? I want to get field induction here. Actually, it was defined at an angle of theta. At an angle of theta,
it was defined.
What is the force acting on this conductor? So, fine. Force. On small conductor. How to do it means same logic. But you have to choose small element here of length dx at a distance of x.
At a distance of x. Okay.
Then I have chosen x here. What is the distance of that point, this point from here? Distance of that element from this one. How much? A plus this value. This value is how much? Cos theta is 0.2. If you let it as a small some value unknown y. That is y by x. Y equal to x cos theta.
Y value what here? X cos theta.
Then what is the B value due to this conductor here? Mu naught I1 by. What is the field induction here due to first conductor is B1 or B. So what we are getting B value? Mu naught I1 by 2 pi distance. A plus x cos theta.
A plus x cos theta. Okay. After applying that force value, sorry, field value,
what is the force on the element? B direction what is it?
Downward.
Dx bar right. So what is the angle between dx and b bar?
90 degrees. What is the force value then? I dx b. What is that?
I do dx b. So the force on the element is equal to. What is the force on the element? ILB
sin theta, but I value what here? I know.
I know dx b sin 90. Sin 90. Okay. Now, how to get a b? What is the b value that you write here?
Mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi a plus x cos theta.
Okay. Into dx.
Now we want the total force. So total force on small cylinder.
Integral
df equal to integral. What are the limits for x here?
X value varying from 0 to 2a. X value varying from 0 to 2a. So by that 0 to 2a,
mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi a plus x cos theta into dx.
Into dx. So what we are getting here? F equal to
mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi
integral dx by
log x.
So what we are getting?
Log of a plus x cos theta by
differentiate this part again. If you differentiate this part, we are getting cos theta.
What we are getting here? Cos theta
d by dx of this value. D by dx of a plus x cos theta equal to cos theta. That differentiation value we need to write in the denominator. Then integration process completely over. Okay. Now,
what are the limits here? Apply the limits here. 0 to 2a.
What we are getting? Mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi cos theta. 2 pi cos theta.
Log of this value substitute here.
Log of a plus 2a cos theta minus log of a.
Log of a.
What we are getting for the limit?
Mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi cos theta into log of a plus 2a cos theta by a.
A
mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi cos theta into
2 pi cos theta into
ln of 1 plus 2 cos theta.
It is the final answer for force.
Final answer of force
on this conductor.
On that conductor. Okay.
Next, one more example we are going to see here. Next example problem.
In our next example,
there is an infinite current carrying conductor, carrying current I1,
carrying current I1.
Beside that, there is a rectangle Y, carrying the current I2. And its distance is the A1. And its length is L, breadth is B. Length is L, breadth is B.
What is the force on the rectangular coil
due to this due to this infinite conductor, there are totally four forces on four sides. Okay, over this, over. What is the four sides called? B bar that is not here involved. Failed due to this one, this side is involved. So, L bar plus B bar. L bar plus B bar upward. So, that is the force that is involved. And similarly, same amount of force will be there on this conductor, but in downward direction. So the force directs in this one in same amount, minus this one cancel. The remaining only two conductors are here. What is the force acting on this? The force acting on the conductor is this one getting attracted because current direction is same here. That force value mu naught I bar I 2 L by 2 pi A. And what is the force direction here? This bar getting attracted. This bar attracted. That means force direction like this. And over that force will be like that. That force value mu naught I bar I 2 L by 2 pi, total distance from here to here, how much? Here times. Then what is the resonant force here? The resonant force is equal to F1 difference F. Because this force is a repelling force, this is attracting force. Both are in the same opposite direction here. What is the resonant? What are common terms here? Mu naught I bar I 2 L by 2 pi come. What's remain? 1 by A minus 1 by A plus B. What is the direction of resonant force? This is the attraction. That is the dominating one here. So by that, the force over that is the right point. Leftward, sorry.
Fourth direction, what here? Leftward.
Okay. So this is the answer for this. So it is one example from the next example. There are three current carrying conductors. There are three current carrying conductors of infinite length. Three current carrying conductors of infinite length carrying the currents I1, I2 and I3. Okay, they are at a separation of R and R. What is the resultant force acting on middle conductor? Question is, find resultant force on middle conductor. Force on middle conductor. Secondly, also find the condition. Also find the condition for becoming resultant force on middle conductor 0. On middle conductor 0. These two we want to now find out what how can we find. the current direction in these two is same direction by that it is attracted by this. And similarly it is attracted by third connector, the second connector like this. What is the force acting in this? That is force on third one due to first one. And what is the force? Force on third one due to second one. What is the magnitudes of them? Force on third one due to first one equal to mu naught I1 I3 by 2 pi r. Mu naught I1 I3 by 2 pi r into L. Okay, what is the force acting on between these two? That is F3 into mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r into L. If you are taking small element of this one as a for this one L. Over that small element, these are the forces. Then this is the force equal to difference of both one. That means mu naught I1 L by I2 I3. Force between these two mean mu naught I2 I3 by 2 pi r. So we are getting what here? Mu naught I1 I3 L by 2 pi r into I1 difference I2. It is a resultant force. Okay. That is the resultant force acting on the middle conductor. Secondly, they ask you, if resultant force is zero, then what happens? This value is equal to zero. That means I1 and I2 both are equal. I1 and I2 both are equal. So the two questions what they asked, we were answered here. So right now this problem. The remaining one will be discussed in the next step. Okay. So with this one, some part of force acting between two parallel current carrying conductors is over. Okay. Thank you so much.